What is a diagnostic cerebral angiogram? A diagnostic cerebral angiogram is a medical procedure that helps specialized doctors examine the blood vessels in the head and neck, including the brain. These doctors are able to examine blood vessels using high-tech imaging equipment to take X-ray pictures. What to expect during your angiogram?
The procedure will take place in a room like this, called the neuroangiography suite. It was designed specifically to perform procedures like yours. You'll lie down here with plenty of cushioning to keep you comfortable while the procedure is done. Your procedure will be performed under sedation. This means that your nurse will give you a combination of medications that will help you relax and remove any uncomfortable sensations.
In addition to the sedation medications, the doctor will also apply numbing medicine to your groin to ease any discomfort in that area. A small tube called a catheter will then be inserted into an artery in your leg called the femoral artery. You may feel some pressure as the catheter is being placed. The femoral artery gives the doctor a direct pathway to the vessels of the head and neck without crossing or coming close to the heart. How is a cerebral angiogram performed? The imaging equipment in the neuroangiography suite uses X-rays to help the doctors guide the catheter to the vessel they want to see. When it is time to take the X-ray pictures of the blood vessels, a contrast medium, or dye, is injected into the vessel through the catheter. This typically produces a warm but not painful feeling that lasts for a few seconds. The imaging equipment may rotate around your head. You may also hear beeping noises as the pictures are taken. These noises help to signal your doctor about the position of the equipment. The X-ray pictures are displayed on screens that the doctors watch as they are performing the procedure. The doctor will look at the pictures more closely once your procedure is finished. What happens after the procedure? At the end of the procedure, the catheter is removed and a closure device is used to seal the site. In selected situations, the doctor holds pressure at that site for 15 to 20 minutes. A Band-Aid is then applied. You will stay here in the recovery room for 5 to 6 hours after the procedure.
Thank you very much for watching. Again, please don't hesitate to share any questions or concerns you have with us. We hope your experience at Johns Hopkins is as pleasant and comfortable as possible.